Good morning, everybody. January 12th, about 8 o'clock in the morning. Today, we plan to load up all this stuff into the back of the truck, load up our food, our clothing in the trailer, and tomorrow morning, take off for my favorite place on earth to camp and ride is Glamis, California. We picked this weekend because it's the one weekend in about six in a row that we can get away with this. And it turns out that it's also the one weekend where it looks like rain and snow, depending upon where you're at here in California, up in the mountains or down here in the flat parts, plan to visit us for like 3 or 4 days in a row. It's already raining lightly here at my house. I still have to drill the holes for the rack and get that up there and do all that. So we have some things to do today. So today, as we're loading, getting things ready, I thought I'd share this little video clip about Glamis, California. For those of you that don't know, you've probably heard something about it. So here it is. Enjoy.
Everybody that's down here at the Imperial Sand Dunes for Thanksgiving must be here now. And I can see over my shoulder, the cars are just going backwards and forwards, the buggies, the bikes, the three-wheelers, the quads, and in there must be some jeeps and also people in their trucks. It's been like this since it got dark, which was early tonight, about 5:30. We've already had fireworks, there's been flares, and as I say, it's absolutely exhilarating and exciting. You can almost feel it vibrating with the amount of energy. Just a great place to be on Thanksgiving.
I have so many awesome memories of camping in Glamis. We've camped other places too, Ocotillo, Pismo Beach, Borrego Springs, Mammoth, other places where we're riding and doing those things. So how we got started going in the sand was, I've been a two-wheel guy my whole life, ridden and raced here and there, and I even raced with my older boy, Jacob, who's now married off, and he's a firefighter paramedic, and I never thought I would ever be a quad guy, a four-wheel guy, but I went to the dunes with some friends, and I was really impressed with the beauty of the place. I was in awe over that, and just how the way the dunes decide to shape themselves become an off-road Disneyland. You know, you're up on the sides of stuff. You can find all kinds of cool jumps and things, and you can link together some really fun stuff. And if you're safe about it and you're smart about it, you can have a great time, you know. Glamis does have its reputation, and like you saw in the video, there's some crazy stuff that goes on there, but we try to go when there's none of that going on, and hopefully in the video that you're going to see after this, it can be a place that's very peaceful and a lot of fun and a lot safer when you decide to go when there's not so many people. So that's how we got started, because going to the sand, kids can't really ride two wheels in the sand. It's kind of difficult, so we just got quads, and we've been doing the sand with quads, but I've grown to love the place so much. It's one of my favorite places. I have so many memories camping with families and groups of 2, 6. We even had a couple groups of like 10. So I'm excited to go back. This is our first trip going back in about 3 years. Last time we were there, we had a 4-seater Razor, and it was me and my boy and my daughter who's gonna go on this trip and my wife, and we did have a great time in the Razor there. But before that, it's been about 6 years since we've gone to go riding. So this will be the first trip, and I'm just really excited. So it'll be cool to bring you guys along.
I'm excited too.
So we're gonna go ahead and load and won't bore you with that video. You've seen that enough. So you just saw me apply that Flex Seal liquid sealer, because one of the things I never finished was this vent top. I had used these screws in my wealth of knowledge on how to build a camper, and after I'd used them, I realized you got to use a screw that seats flat. And so you saw me swap those out, and then I ran a coating of that Flex Seal to waterproof it, because we are anticipating rain on this trip. So I've done a full inspection of the roof. Everything else looks sealed. So this will be the test trip if it rains. So we got her done. Here we go. All right, so as I'm getting these final touches done in preparation to go camping, I got the sealer on there, which we're gonna need because it's raining again. It's been spotty today, so I've been able to get some stuff done. You saw that I got the holes drilled to mount the racks, and then I got that rack painted earlier this morning when it was sunny, so it's sitting out there in the rain. But I've been putting coats on this one, and I've had to pull it inside out of the rain. I'm just gonna paint it right here, just let the thing dry. Our rain here is only supposed to be for a few hours today, then it's gonna dissipate, and I looked at the radar and that's exactly what it looks like it's gonna do. So, and as soon as this thing passes, sun will come out for a little bit. In fact, it's already sunny over there. So once this little splotch passes, get back to loading. All right, we were able to get the painting part done. She's looking pretty good. All painted up there. Got her bolted in, and we'll start. Keep on going here. Sun did come out, just like we thought. Okay, all you happy campers, we are loaded up. It is 5:30. It's basically taken me about 3 hours to figure out the configuration for all this, but underneath here is loaded. 3 gear bags, 4 5-gallon water jugs, a porta potty, a generator, a compressor, 2 rolls of carpet, a sled, 6 bundles of firewood, a table, 2 tables, 10 gallons of fuel. Topped them all off.
Freezing.
This is going to ride here. It's on here good. We have another cooler just resting between the wheels. It's not going anywhere. We have another roll of carpet here. Everything is tied down. And we're gonna park these inside tonight, and then tomorrow we'll just hook up and we'll go. The only place I could put those huge ramps was right here. But they're on there, and they're on there tight. They're not going anywhere. Okay, so we're gonna leave O-Dark 30 in the morning and get a jump on the sun. So that's it, man. We'll see you guys in the morning.